As court resumed today before Justice Alice Komhanji, prosecution led by Lillian Omala informed the court that they had secured 150 exhibits which they had already disclosed to the defense team. Prosecution asked the court to allow them mark these exhibits. These exhibits include the vehicle of the late Kawesi, bullet cartridges, a recovered gun and phones of the suspects, among others. These were inspected by both the prosecution and defense teams in August last year. Omala asked the court to give them more time to prepare for the pre-trial conferencing of the matter. Prosecution also informed court that one of the suspects, Shafiq Kasuja, had jumped bail for close to a year and his whereabouts are still unknown. Consequently, court issued criminal summons for Kasuja.
Physical exhibits, those are the exhibits which we saw then, including the car of the late which he was driving, includes the clothes he was putting on then. They include several bullets. They include also several projectiles and the telephone numbers which were got, or the telephone lines and the phones themselves which were got from our accused persons. Now, that is all the total of 150 evidence which the state exhibited in court and also delivered, exhibited to us. Now, today we have marked them, though we have not proceeded with the pre-conferencing hearing, reason being one of the accused persons is not present.
The eight suspects are Abdurrashid Mazira, Hamza Higeni, Shafiq Kasuja, Yusuf Mugirwa, Bruhan Baliejusa, Joshua Chambade, Jibril Kaliango, and Yusuf Nyanzi. Prosecution states that the group between January and March 2017 in diverse districts of Kampala, Wakiso, Mukono, Jinja, Iganga, Bujiri, Busia, and Tororo, for purposes of influencing the government, planned Kawesi's killing. Still in court, Kampala High Court has set 24th April to give its verdict in a case in which Abubakar Kalunji is accused of murdering Assistant Superintendent of Police Muhammad Chirumira and Restim Babazi. This was after the two court assessors asked court to exonerate Kalunji on grounds that there was insufficient evidence to pin him. The assessors, including Jacqueline Nafula and Jacqueline Nabufu, agree with the defense team that the accused person had been tortured and forced to confess that he was behind Chirumira's murder.
Above views, we are not convinced as per participation of the accused. We therefore advise this honorable court to find the accused person not guilty of offense as charged and acquit him accordingly. We so advise.
Chirumira and Mbabazi were gunned down by unknown people on the 8th of September 2018 in Bulenga, Wakiso District. Subsequently, several people were arrested and the Director of Public Prosecutions started prosecuting the case. Two men, Hamza Mwebe and Abubakar Kalunji, have been appearing before the court to answer charges of murder. However, on the 23rd of December 2022, Judge Margaret Mutoni acquitted Mwebe after prosecution failed to prove the reason for his arrest and his connection to the case. Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.